Today we will discuss about constant temperature process, or sometimes it is called as the isothermal process, or sometimes called as the hyperbolic process. So welcome to my YouTube channel, Mechanical Engineering Management. Consider the gas is filled in a cylinder with movable piston as shown in figure A. This is the cylinder, in which this is the piston. And this space is filled with the gas. So this is considered as a system. And here we are talking about isothermal process, that means constant temperature process. So temperature is constant. Let's say it is figure A. So if I want to show the initial position of the gas on PV diagram, then it is like that, pressure versus volume diagram. So this pressure is always on the y axis and volume is always on the x axis. And this is the initial state of the gas. Let's say it is the state 1 and corresponding pressure is P1 and corresponding volume is V1 for the state 1. So this is actually initial state of the gas. Now next, when the heat is supplied to the gas, its volume increases as shown in figure B. So first try to understand over here what happened due to the heat supplied. Volume is increased, that you can see, and now it is the final position of the gas, that means the state 2. So if I want to show the state 2 on the PV diagram, then it will be over here. And corresponding pressure P2 and corresponding volume V2. And this process 1-2 is known as constant temperature process. And as we have discussed, that constant temperature process is also known as hyperbolic process because of the shape of that curve is hyperbola. So keep in mind that isothermal process is always curve on the PV diagram. So let's say it is figure B. Now first point, relation between pressure, volume and temperature during isothermal process. So as we know that general characteristic gas equation PV upon T is equal to constant. So I can say P1 V1 upon T1 for state 1 is equal to P2 V2 by T2 for state 2. And as you know, the temperature is constant, that means T1 is equal to T2. So it will be cancelled from both sides. So the remaining term is P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. And this is the important relation for the constant temperature process. So make a box. Here you can understand, if this is the constant temperature process, the product of pressure and volume is always constant for each and every state. Now next, work done. So this is actually work done, that means area below this curve, or you can say below this process 1-2, that represent actually work done. As you know that work done is equal to integration of PdV, and this is the process 1-2, and dV is the change in volume. So here you know that pressure is also varying, that is not actually constant, and you know that P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. So in general I can say PV is equal to constant. So I can write over here PV is equal to P1 V1 is equal to constant. So from this equation I can write P is equal to P1 V1 upon V. And now I can put this value over here. So you can see P is equal to P1 V1 upon V dV as it is. So P1 V1 is actually constant. So I can take it outside of this integration, and remaining term is 1 upon V. So P1 V1 as it is, and you know that integration of 1 upon V is ln V, limit 1-2 as it is. Now next, this is my previous page and I am going to simplify over here this work done. So W is equal to P1V1 as it is. And here if I put the limit, then it is ln V2 minus ln V1, and so that it is ln V2 by V1. So this is also very important relation that you have to remember. The work done during the isothermal process is P1V1 ln V2 by V1. Now next, change in internal energy, and that is denoted by du. And that also you know that mCv integration of dt during the process 1 to 2. So simply you can say mC dt. So du is equal to 0, because dt is the change in temperature, and here we are talking about the isothermal process, that means temperature is constant. So you can understand dt is equal to 0 for the constant temperature process, and so that change in internal energy is 0. So make a box, and that you should remember, for the constant temperature process or for the isothermal process, change in internal energy is 0. Next, heat transferred. So according to the first law of thermodynamics, we know that Q is equal to W plus du. So already we have derived the equation for the work done, P1V1 ln V2 by V1, plus du, that is 0. So if you simplify, then it is very simple. Q is equal to P1V1 ln V2 by V1. So make a box. This is very important relation of the heat transfer during the constant temperature process. Now next, change in enthalpy is denoted by dh, and that is equal to mCp dt, where dt, that means the change in temperature. So here also you know that change in temperature T2 minus T1 is equal to 0 for isothermal process, and so that dh is equal to 0. So make a box. So here keep in mind that dt, that means change in temperature, and for isothermal process temperature is constant, and so that dt is equal to 0, so change in internal energy is 0. Similarly over here, this is dt, and so that it is also 0. So thanks my dear friends, press the like button to appreciate this video.